welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to investigate the Kendrick Lamar style. Now Kendrick Lamar is back and he's releasing some of his jazz-influenced music again, finally in hip-hop. So what I love about Kendrick Lamar's brand at this point is that he's pushing hip-hop into his own thing, which is like this jazzier, dark kind of lane. So we're just going to look for different samples. What's going on, Gucci Prada? Today's live stream is going to be pretty quick because I have some things I got to take care of. So the best troll, Neymar, is here. Tommy is here. Nelson is here. Robert's here. What's going on? Ghetto Wealth is here. Jamie's here. So we have the ingredients listed here. I might start with my vocals, actually. Deity is here. DJ, what's the DJ One? Alawale, if I'm saying that right. Scopes is here. Jamie's here. What's going on? Welcome. I like the organization of Nexus. Yes, I do think it's working. Okay. So thank you. So we're going to be moving pretty quickly through this. First step is to set the BPM to about 94 BPM. We're in like the old 90s hip hop BPMs. I'm going to record my vocals and record like doo-doo-doo-doo, that type of background stuff. Now, firstly, let me open up Auto-Tune because I can't sing. And Auto-Tune makes me sound so much better. Let's put it on low latency mode, low male for me because I have a low frequency voice so I can pick up the pitch range. And let's turn that retune speed pretty quick. So now when I go doo-doo-doo, now that's probably too fast. Let's switch that to about 10 or 20. And if it's too much, I might even do it at the end. So let's just record with it on and come up with different ideas. Then we'll harmonize. So we're starting out with the vocal idea at 94 BPM. I'm just going to make sure my microphone's track's on. Arm disc for recording. Click on the track, hit record. And let's record audio into playlists. Wow, I sound like an amateur, but let's do higher notes. Let's just harmonize it. This would be great if you could actually sing. Let's send those tracks to track 1 and 2 and let's pan those opposite. So it sounds like, you know, 2 different takes. Whoops. It's a little, you know, stale because the auto-tune kind of grips it to one note, but whatever. You know, we don't have to make this perfection. But... I might redo the main line. I'm gonna give it a little more energy. And that way we can pan that left and right and then the new harmony in the middle. I think I sang the wrong note, but whatever. Okay, so we're going to send that to track 3. And let's keep the higher pitch one pan center. Now... You know, it'd be better to have a female on this to kind of make it a contrast, but it doesn't really matter. Now let's grab the one in the middle. Let's add a filter, a low pass filter, parametric EQ 2. Let's change this filter type to a low pass filter to muffle out the sound. Now we're going to do that for each track. Let me see here. Let's add a little saturation on the one in the middle. I'm going to use Decapitator as our saturation. And let's turn it up. Whoops. Okay, now I don't want the vocals to distract me, so let's add a low-pass filter on each. Now we can always go back and add the vocals to make it more finessed, but... We're trying to build ground material right now. So let's add these low pass filters. And then we're going to get into the chords. So I want like a boom bap type of thing. But instead of boom bap, let's do boom, 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 boom. So the kick's going to hit. Now I have some raw samples. Let me see. We're looking for more retro style drums here. So a kick like this, something very dusty sounding. Let me normalize it. And I'm actually going to go to the wrench tool, turn up the volume to crank it even further. Just so it really pumps. So that's a dark kick. I call that a dark kick because it's not too bright. It doesn't have a lot of high frequency information. Let's go to snare. See if we can find a matching snare. This one's okay. Could be better. This one's nice and dark. So we're looking for a snare head, not a snare rim shot. I'm trying to find which one has the right tone. Let's try this one out. And okay, so the drums aren't going to be the punchiest thing ever. That's one thing I want you to understand. Let's add that into the playlist. You know, we're not going for trap drums here. Let's go to snap the grid bar mode. And we're going to put the kick on every beat. So it's boom, 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 boom. So it's a four to the floor kick. Now I like that kind of rhythm. I did that by accident, but that sounded kind of cool. So let's kind of take that dance rhythm from, you know, a Drake track and just add that in. It adds a little bit of an island sound. Listen for the snare. And I still think we could layer a snare, so let's add that second snare in there. And what I'm going to do is go to this snare, the second one, switch it from mode to resample. I forgot I have auto-tune on my voice. You could have told me that. Okay. So let's go back. Let's go send that to track 6. Now for the second snare, we're going to go to the wrench tool, turn time shift up. So it's delayed behind the first snare. So very dark drums, nothing spectacular. Now we can mix it to sound a little more present, but very simple drums. Let's add in a hi-hat, an open hi-hat and a hi-hat. Now I'm probably not going to have that in my raw samples folder, so let's go to X Drums. Let's grab some hi-hats from X Drums. So I like that hi-hat panning, so let's right-click open a new channel. And also like the counterpart open hi-hat to that. I think it's from the same record. So let's send that to track 7, track 8. And I want to throw an open hi-hat in there every now and then. And then we're going to work in the regular closed hi-hat. So 1, 2, 3, and doom. All right. Now let's add the closed hi-hat in here. Let's just right-click fill each 2 steps. Very simple pattern. Okay, I mean, it's very common. Let's just turn this stuff down in the mix. Now, the open hi-hat to me is, the closed hi-hat to me is a little too fast. So let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. Yo, I really like your tutorials, but want to know if you can do more FL only. I plan to. We should be streaming, excuse me, for those around the world at different times. So hopefully tonight we'll be rolling for you. So let's add some life to this. Let's add some chords. Now the sound you want to go for is more of a Wurlitzer versus, you know, Rhodes. So let's load up Lounge Lizard because it's quick to load. And let's go to their banks. Let's switch this to a Wurlitzer. Gives you more of that bitey tone. And now we can play those nice thick chords. So let's figure out which chords match this. Okay, now we can, again, you can always go back and do the vocals. We're just using that as building material. So let's open up Piano Roll, close out the browser for now. So we're doing D, C, B, A. Okay, those are the four notes we're using. So we're basically using all the white notes. Let's pull this up an octave. So let's try some, you know, chords here. So since D is our top note here, I'm going to work backwards. Instead of using D as our root note, I'm going to assume that's the top note of some chord, and we're going to skip every other chord. That gives us E minor 7. This is an option. So let's add this into the track just to see how it fits. And if it's not the right fit, we can always rearrange it. You can see that's super harsh sounding. Let's turn the volume down. It's a little too jazzy. a little too happy. Let's make that G minor. Or we could just switch out the chord. So let's do D minor. Too bright. Let me play around to see if we can find a chord better. Let's do, what was that? So we're playing A minor at first, then we're gonna do glissando notes in here. So let me show you what that is. So we're gonna go from the root note to the note above that, a half, or you know, the next note in the scale, putting those really close together so it creates a slide. Now I probably could have sang a little bit better than that. Now, my ear wants to bring that down to F sharp, so let's see what chord that would be. We're just going to hit Control A, hit Shift, left click, and pull everything down to F sharp. So that's the top note. So that would make that E minor. And that sounds pretty cool. Now, my singing could be a lot better. That's what's throwing it off. So let's turn off the singing for just a quick sec. So because I chose the F sharp, it took it outside of the scale I was singing in. So we're going to have to re-sing that. Now I'm going to hit shift, transpose, pull everything relatively over to A now. And then again, we're just hitting shift, making sure that top note is what we hear in our head. If I mute the vocals, we're gonna have to redo the scale. Still not as luscious as we want, so let's start adding some effects to the piano. We need chorusing, so I'm gonna add Fruity Chorus. And that gives it more of a detuned sound, so just in case you're out of scale. And that gives us that emotional sound. Let's add a little reverb, Fruity Reverb too. Automatics and I'm cheap, roll back with it, don't act so I'm. We gon' get it in the automatic, so I'm. We gon' tear it down in the so I'm. I think it needs to be a little faster. Story, survive the story. Survive the stories, but no one's told me. That's the story. So, alright. Let's see what else we need in here. So, vocals are really the last step. Now, if I could sing, that would be awesome. Let's do that. Okay, so I'm just gonna do that. So I screwed up on one note, which is fine. We can always chop it out. So let's get rid of the original vocal. Let's create our own type of vibe. And we're gonna add vocal effects. I'm gonna show you a couple things, but let's get that one note right because it's a little off. And what I could do is actually just cut it. Let me see here. Cut it. Let's go to snap to grid none. Let's hold shift. Let's left click and cut that first note. So that way all I have to do is go to snap to grid bar mode. Left click, hit shift, left click, and pull it over. So I have to get those notes in my head so I can sing them right the next time. So let me see. All Okay. All right. Had to remember that. So the magic happens when you have multiple takes. This is one thing I love about harmonies. When you're one person, you don't really, the only way you can achieve that is if you do multiple takes. So it's a very produced sound. It's not a natural sound, especially coming from one person. So we also need a bass line in here somewhere. So now I have to come up with a different thing. Like instead of I have to do something different, like a seventh. So, you know, something like that. So let's, I'll struggle through this, but let's try it. I cannot say. Whew, ran out of breath. Listen to the track 12. Oh, it was a struggle in the beginning. Wow, it's really a struggle. I might just try it one more time. But if it's a waste, then I'm just going to leave the two and we can work on that later. So the harmony, I'm using like a fifth to kind of harmonize it. Why do I sound like I'm a vibrato? It sounds more natural when I do it that way. I don't know why auto-tune's auto-correcting it. You know, a couple notes are off, whatever. You got to get the idea down or else you're not going to see the bigger picture. So let's add some vocal effects. So let's work on the harmonized sound first. And what I want to do is saturate it a little tiny bit with decapitator. And then I'm going to add tons of reverb, but in mono. So let's do fruity reverb too. Since the vocal is pan center, I want to keep the reverb mono since everything else is pan left and right. Sorry for missing your comments. Does Omnisphere have vocal sounds? Yes, it does have choir sounds in there. Not very I mean, they sound human, but they're not like legato style vocals. They're more choir sounds. Let's pull this to mono separation and give it a nice decay. Thank you, Sonar. So that's giving it the vibe, that mono reverb. Very cool retro vibe. Let's add a little chorusing to the stereo. Fruity chorus. Let's add that for both tracks. Let's just click Save Preset As and drag it over. This needs a little auto-tune. Let's just try a little tiny auto-tune. Low latency mode. Let's go to low male. Let's pull it down to about 10 milliseconds or so. But if it sounds too robotic, I'm going to pull it back. Yeah, see how it goes? You know, I was singing the right note the first time, but it's picking up on the wrong note. So what I'm going to do is just tuck the worst vocal behind. So we still get the tone without people hearing the audio flaws. I flills you, Manu. Let's add a bass line. So let's open up Trillion. I understand a lot of you don't have Trillion. I didn't have it for a really long time. So don't, no worries. Just pick any bass you feel comfortable with. I'm just picking Trillion. Okay, I thought Sankus crashed the stream. No, welcome, Sankus. Yeah. So for all those wondering where Sankus's video stuff is, we have something special coming up soon, and we really have to make sure Sankus gets the appropriate attention on his work, because he puts out so much great work that you can't just throw his stuff out anytime, anywhere. So just quick side note, you will see Sankus very soon. We have something special coming for you. So I have to keep details under wraps, but that's where Sankus is. So if you're missing Sankus, go to his channel. That's kind of why we have the backlinks to his channel. Let's open up Trillium. Let's scroll down to bass electric. Let me see, should I be picked or no, fingered? Now some of these basses, I haven't gone through all of them. Let's do studio, warm full range. Let's try this one out, because it probably is less high end. Same with Curtis King as well. It's not just Sankus. It's all our partners. But yeah, what's coming in the future for BusyWorks Beats is really exciting, and I can't really wait till it happens, but I can't give tons of details. I don't know if I should do a verse to this. I don't know if I have enough time, actually, because I got to get in and out today, but we're going to be up late, so no worries. So as this loads, I might do a vocal bass, actually. That might be better. So. Yeah, let me do that. I had a lot more character in my voice than any bass guitar I could ever play MIDI in. That's why you want to find people who are good at playing instruments, because they can make that humanized sound in the instrument instead of it sounding like boom, 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 you know, very stale bass. So let's program the vocals to sound more bass-like. Let's open up the track. Let's pull up Parametric EQ2. First thing we're going to do is open up the low shelf, pull that up so the bass frequencies are enhanced to feel as if we're... What's up, I Know Gamer Tag? There he is. Haven't talked to Kevin in so while. You're ridiculous. What's going on, man? Let's make this bass a little bit cooler. Now, if it sounds too human and too vocally, you know, vocal, add a low pass filter to get rid of some of that human element. Thank you, I Know Gamer Tag. I'm your number one fan. What's going on, Big A? I see you changed your avatar finally. So at this point, you could split it and kind of get rid of stuff. Maybe you do like half time on your vocals or something crazy. Split it up into two sections. So let's take out the vocal and see how we hear. Whoops, that's not where we're going. Control Z. Get rid of these vocals. Maybe I'll do a quick freestyle. This is mine and Kendrick. I want to move that open hi-hat. I want it to be more of a... Wait. Let me see. Let's make that a clone. Let's clone that so we have options here for the open hi-hat placement. That way it's not the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over again. Over and over and over again. Now I like that little stutter, probably every four. So let's hit Control Shift, left click, and highlight every fourth. Let's click here, select source pattern, and change that to pattern. Wait, pattern three, I think. Yeah, pattern three. No, wait, I did it backwards. Let's do it this way. Okay, I need to change all pattern two to pattern three. Okay, so let's do it this way. Let's highlight every first three. So every fourth is pattern two. That way, here we go. Let's click here, go to select source pattern, pattern three. And we're pretty much done. I mean, there's no other instrumentation except the vocals that we already added. Now you can hype up the vocals with delay and different things. So let's do that at least. Add a fruity delay to each side vocal. I appreciate you all for joining. I got to keep moving today because we're going to be headed out. But again, we're going to be streaming later for those who are in different countries. So we're respecting everybody's time zones here. Let's go to input. Set that to 2. And then ping pong mode. Actually, we don't want it on ping pong. Let's do normal, low volume input, lower feedback so that you don't get a long tail. And I'm on the wrong track, so let's send that over. Okay, so let's click here, save preset as, drag that atop. One sec, I'm gonna get to your questions in a sec. Thank you, Husky. Stuff out of my life says, how do you do the numbers before the kick? If you're in FL Studio 12 or and above, hit Alt plus M. Alt plus M. We might do the 808 slides part of that song. Heartbeat part 4. But I think we already covered it enough. We could beef up the bass a little bit. Let's saturate it with some Fruity Blood Overdrive. I'm trying to stick with native plugins. How do you open the playlist? You click this button right here. Let's work on the drums a little bit. Kick sounds pretty cool. Let's just add a little more punch. Let's do transient shaper or transient processor from image line. Just make it cut through a little tiny bit more. Uruguay in the building. Welcome. Now the snare is a little low, but remember we have two snares and combined their volume is a lot louder than what's showing up. So, you know, there's not a lot of texture here. So what we want to do is pull that up. The new one, Kendrick song, Humble. It was different. You know, if he can make it work, then go for it. That type of beat. It sounded like FL Keys. Like, honestly, I think somebody used FL Keys on that, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I used Wave. Let's add a compressor to that snare. Let's do a Fruity compressor. Whoa. Let me add this compressor to the snare real quick. So the compressor is trying to pull up the body of the snare so that we can add EQ to it. So let me solo it just so you can hear what's going on. Let me see. All right, so my mic's open. Let's... Now it's a very short snare, so there's not much to grab onto. So let's grab the attack at 0 and then run it through maybe 2-to-1 or higher compression. Then we're going to pull the threshold down. Now you're not going to hear it until the volume dips. And I can hear it. So let's crank up the output gain. So we're just trying to pull up that scraping sound. I'm exaggerating the volume so you can hear it. So here's without. It's just like, doop, and then it stops. But now it's like, scrap, scrape a little bit. Let's add EQ. Let's get rid of some of the low mid content and let's pull up on the high shelf to brighten that snare up a bit. This is a layered snare, so it's not about the punch, it's about the tone. There we go. One more trick you could do for the bass I did, you can go to your bass and lower your pitch -1200. That will lower it down an octave.
Hey, what's up for the reefer?
Let me freestyle and then we're gonna wrap it up, okay? So I wanted to keep this short. Now Kendrick Lamar has way more bars than me off the top of the head, so whatever comes in my head, I'm just gonna say it. All right.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put a paper on the rock, then feed. Put that paper on the table, then feed us. We want vino, sipping vino on a pino, Grigio, tip though. Yeah, I cut throats on the rip though. Yeah, I fuck holes on the dip though. Yeah, all black grip though. Yeah. TDE for show, acting with a rat 10 and we rappin'.
Yeah, I kind of lost the flow because I stuttered on feed. So let's cut that part out.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put it paper on the rock then.
I meant to say put the bread on the table then feed us, but whatever.
Believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just. Believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put it paper on the rock, then feed. Put that paper on the table, then feed us. We won't be.
Alright, so I'm gonna cut that part out and just replace it with the second bar. Now the rest was just whack, so we're gonna cut that out. Now again, you don't have to do this. This is just for more advanced producers who want to give people an idea of what the beat sounds like with them on it.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not.
So let me show you what we would do on the vocals. We'd add a high pass filter.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer.
Because his vocal octave is way higher than mine.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer.
Boost up around 2500, add some air at about 8k and above.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please put that paper on the table, then feed us. Jesus, please put that paper.
Alright, so I'm trying to put these words together so they make sense. There we go.
Jesus, please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game.
Why do we use mid-side EQ? The reason we do that is to create custom sounds, just like why sound design. You know, why not? There's different ways to do supersols. So same thing with mid-side EQ. Sometimes you want your soundscape to be a little bit different.
Jesus, please just.
And
I'm getting high.
You're really creating an image in the mind, so
I'm getting high.
That involves like a 180 perception. It's not just center, left and right. It's a 180 thing. So that's why we use mid-side EQ. I use it more on pads.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh.
And we're going to add that mono reverb and then we're going to wrap it up. Because we don't need to do much else.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us.
Maybe we'll do a part two where we go over the 808 slide part, but that's pretty basic. I use a Focusrite Scarlett 18i20 for my interface.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer.
Let me add a little mastering just so it gives you a better perspective. But again, remember, increasing your audio buffer will give it a cleaner sound.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put.
See, we're clipping on the master, so there's a lot of steps in mixing, but I'm just gonna lower the input.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us.
Yeah, live streams, we're still coming up with a schedule. The mic is a U87 by Neumann, a U87 by Neumann. You don't need this mic, but Neumann have great mics. Live streams, we're still working on the schedule. Is it fine if I use...
I'm getting high and
yes.
Not from
my
the reefer.
Yes, man.
I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us.
So I'm just adding a little color tone and boosting up the bass at 100 on the master.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus.
Now I'm just gonna add a limiter.
Put that paper on the table, then feed us.
About to get louder.
I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. On the table, then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. Then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us. Then feed us. I'm getting high and not from the reefer. I'm running the game and not in no sneakers. Oh, believers, we disciples like Jesus. Please just put that paper on the table, then feed us.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is give you these project files for free. It takes a little bit to upload, so give it some time for those who are on the live stream. But you want to go to busyworksbeats.com. Let me put this in the chat. Go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. And when you sign up with your email, you will get these project files for free. So give me about 30 to an hour to upload the project files for you. It will come with the audio. It does not come with plugins like Trillion. It doesn't come with Lounge Lizard. So what I'm going to do is just give you the wave version of the, what you call it, wave version of the tracks. So you can work with it in audio form. All right. And that way it's a win-win for everybody. So go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Again, in 1 hour or so, it should be up. And if not, we're going to send it to you anyway. So no worries. You're going to get it. Okay. So click that link below if you're watching this after the live stream on a replay. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.